is this, a Supra?
Hey guys, welcome to Brick Hub. Today I'm going to review the LEGO Speed Champions Toyota GR Supra. As always, if you guys enjoy this video, be sure to smash that like button, comment down below to let me know what you think, and subscribe to this channel, hitting that notification bell. Also, check out our Instagram page. So first things first, as I mentioned before, this is the Toyota GR Supra, rated ages 7+, set number 76901, and has 299 pieces. This set currently retails in the United States for $20. Taking a look on the back, on the left side, you see the back side of the model, whereas on the right side, you see the real life car. This is the final build of the Toyota GR Supra.
Whoa! Is that a Supra?
When the first pictures of this set were released, I was honestly a little bit disappointed. I did not think this set looked very good at all, but having built it and having it in person, I can say it really does not disappoint. For those that don't know the history behind the Toyota Supra, it's a legendary street racing car that was really popular in the 90s, and this was the latest rendition of it that came out just a couple years ago. As far as the angles of the car, it's a little bit difficult to achieve just because it is LEGO, but they did a much better job than I would have expected them to. Probably my favorite part of this design is the back side because, first of all, you get this printed GR logo for Gazoo Racing, which is Toyota's in-house racing development team. And in the back, you have this JDM-style brake light with a dual exhaust. These two symbols, the Toyota symbol and the Supra symbol, are unfortunately stickers, but I do think that this backside just really does look like the real car. I do think these edges could have kind of come in a little bit somehow, but we don't have the pieces for them yet, so I can understand why they weren't able to achieve that. Turning around to the other side, you can see that it's pretty much the same as the right side. And then another side that I really like is the front of this car. The front side, you would think, is a little bit difficult to achieve because of the angles, and unfortunately this is not as smooth as I would have liked. I would have liked them to make some sort of new piece to make these way more curved because I really don't like the break in the headlights. I tried to make them line up as well as I could with the stickers, and I think I did a pretty good job, but it's still not perfect. But I also really like this front splitter design with the vents. And just like the real car, these vents are blocked off because they're not real vents, unfortunately. Pulling open the cabin, there's a divider or a armrest, if you will, and then the driver's wheel. And this is kind of a weird design. I wish they would have done this differently, but the backrest for the seats, it's almost just like a bench seating as opposed to a regular just two-seater. I think that they should have split up in the middle, but honestly, it was still a pretty good attempt. So for a better look at the minifigure, this minifigure is wearing the Gazoo Racing jacket. On the back it says Toyota, and on the front it says GR. And unlike a lot of Speed Champion sets, this one actually has an alternate expression, but comes with a regular helmet. You can just slide it on just like that, and he's a standard race car driver. And that's pretty much it. Overall, I think this car could have been a little bit smaller, but considering the scale of the new Speed Champions, I think they just wanted to keep them all the same size because this is a much smaller car in scale in person. They made this about the same size as the new Speed Champions Ferraris or the Koenigseggs in terms of its length and width, but in real life, it is way, way smaller, probably like 3/4 of the size. As far as the angles achieved, I think they did a much better job than I could have imagined. This is a very, very curvy car, so this would have been very difficult to achieve. As far as value goes, I think for $20, it is a little bit expensive. I would say it's probably closer to a $16 value, but it is still an excellent design, and if you've got to have it now, I wouldn't blame you for paying full price. So that's it for this video, guys. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to smash that like button, comment down below to let me know what you think, and subscribe to this channel, hitting that notification bell. Thanks, guys. Bye.